Hi everyone, and welcome back to your weekly briefing. Today we're going to be talking about something at the forefront of the media's attention, gun control. As most of you know, there was a shooting at Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida on February 14th, where 17 students and faculty members were killed by Nicholas Cruz, a 19-year-old former student who was able to get access to an AR-15, which is a semi-automatic assault rifle. In 2018 alone, there have been 17 shootings, five of which fit under the definition of a mass shooting. Let me remind you, we are only in February. In past shootings, the public and the media have forgotten about it and let it fade out in the news cycle within a couple of days, but the aftermath of this shooting has been completely different. Instead of adults making false promises on change, students have been standing up and saying this is enough. Many of the survivors in the Parkland shooting have been helping to organize a march on March 24th in Washington, D.C., and nationwide school walkouts to demand stricter gun control laws. Okay, so let's break this down. At 18 years old, you can buy a semi-automatic assault rifle, but you cannot drink alcohol. Right, because it's a lot safer for teenagers to handle assault rifles than drink wine. That makes a lot of sense. I'm just gonna say this right now. No 18-year-old should have access to an assault rifle. No civilian should have access to an assault rifle. There is zero purpose for assault rifles other than to assault. They are not hunting weapons, they are not protection weapons, they are killing weapons. Arming teachers is not the answer. Arming teachers will add fuel to the flame in a mistake that will lead to countless more tragedies. Students, including myself, should not go to school each day wondering whether they'll come home that night. So to President Trump, Marco Rubio, Dana Lash, and every other politician or spokesperson not standing up and demanding stricter gun control laws, we call BS.